Hi everyone, my name is Michelle. You're watching part 3 of my series on masking in ZBrush. In the last episode, we looked at how to combine two polygraphs into one polygraph using two methods. Today, we will look at how to mask and polygraph the lip area and the mouth cavity using curve stroke brush. Let's open up a new female demo head project by pressing comma, click on project, and double click on female demo head. Press F to center the model head. Turn off perspective by pressing P so that the model is not distorted while we are editing. As usual, let's divide it up to 800,000 so that we can be as accurate as possible. Press X to turn off symmetry. Green mask half of the head to isolate it so that we can see the cross section. Turn it to the side. We can only see the front surfaces and the back surfaces are invisible. Let's turn on the invisible surfaces, go to Tools, scroll down to the bottom of the palette, look for Display Properties, and click on Double to turn it on. Let's analyze. Okay, we need to turn off the subtool for eyeballs and teeth, so that we don't damage them and they don't block our view. From this view, we can see that we need to mask from the tip of the nose to the bottom of the chin to capture the whole mouth cavity. Ctrl-Shift-Tab. Ctrl-Shift-Lasso. Mask from the front, then isolate just the front part of the face. Turn to the back view and hide all that is not required. We only need to mask the lips and the mouth cavity. At this stage, we can clearly see that it's easier to isolate the mouth cavity and polygraph it first. Let's do that and Ctrl W to polygraph it. Then unhide everything. Once again, isolate from the tip of the nose to the bottom of the chin. Hide the rest. Holding down Ctrl, change the stroke to freehand and paint in the approximate shape of the lips. Holding down Ctrl, change the stroke to curve. Press Ctrl Alternate and slice away the mask area, which goes beyond the lip area. Left to right, masks the top. Right to left, masks the bottom. Hold down Spacebar to move the position of the starting point. You can also use this to change the direction of the curve line. You can bend this curve mask line by pressing Alt once. Press Alternate twice for a sharp angle. If you need to change the direction, just press Spacebar and then move it to change the direction. Once done, rotate to the back and check the extent of masking. Add more mask where needed before pressing Ctrl or Command W to polygraph it, and that's it. These are all the basics of masking you need to get started. In the next episode, I'll be showing you how to use the transpose smart masking to isolate the tongue from the teeth subtool into a different polygroup. That's it for this video. Remember to click like and subscribe if you find my video useful. And do visit my webpage at MitchTinTin.com for a more in-depth tutorial. See you in the next video. Bye!